Yeah, I mean, ear stuff. Hello. Looking like absolute trash today. Need to go walk. Need to be out. The weather's really nice. I should be out. It's really hot though. But it's like not wet hot, so it's fine. Today we're starting this finally. Fall starts now. I'm making it start now. We're doing this. Either or, Elif Batuman. It is such an obnoxious size. Gonna use it as like a visor as I walk around. Maybe I'll wear a hat today. Who knows? I say I do things and I do something differently. Let's go out. I just want to say, recording in 4K truly makes a difference. Hello, a few updates. Here to talk to you about Bliss Montage. Finished it a few days ago. Stories of 100 ex-boyfriends, a drug that makes you disappear, a wife whose husband literally walks away from her in a foreign land and to be buried himself for a midsummerish ritual, a Lion, the Witch, and Wardrobe scenario, of a place where time doesn't exist and it's always night without Mr. Tumnus. Yeah, we have really fabulous stories in this collection. This collection is a crowd pleaser in cruise control. I don't think there's a story in here that you, maybe one or two where you'll go meh, but yeah, there's just some really wacky worlds. If anything, these stories feel like a Twilight Zone marathon without any of the horror elements to them. Then again, Twilight Zone wasn't like really scary, but yeah, they're just these like very interesting worlds with very interesting predicaments, and you have these characters that have choices and you sort of follow along to the choices that they make. One story in particular I thought was incredible because it mentions a Lydia Davis story, and I'm a Lydia Davis stan, just love the way that she crafts sentences and narratives. She has short stories that go on for 8 pages. She has ones that are just a paragraph long, even like one line long. But it references her story of a man who says his favorite memory is actually a memory of his wife's. And it's this idea of reframing narrative. The story is Peking, as in Peking duck, in Ling Ma's collection. But yeah, really makes you think, along with the other stories, what do you claim? What do you own when in speech act? What makes something yours in naive insecurity? And how do you assume authorship? It makes me think of the title, which is taken from Janine Basinger's book, A Woman's View, which describes Bliss montage as something that interrupts many movies. It's the leading lady can be seen laughing her head off, dressed in fabulous clothes, racing along the water in a speedboat, her yachtsman lover at her side. The Bliss montage is a woman's small piece of action, her marginal territory of joy. Those borders were guarded at fade out. There had to be a man and a woman, newly joined or about to be, with a future full of traditional gender roles. Article from Hazlitt by Chris Randall. Yeah, you're usually met with these female protagonists who are experiencing these moments of joy for themselves. So acute, yet so profound in a way. There are these overlooked moments, these invisible moments that these characters experience for themselves. And yeah, they almost feel like miracles in a way. These tiny moments in your life that shape you in large ways. And what I find to be the issue with most short story collections is that they're either a mixed bag and the ones that you don't like are not memorable at all. But I found that some of these ones were quite memorable, minus maybe one or two. But yeah, there's a woman who makes love with a Yeti. A story about a woman who grows a baby arm and you don't even want to know where. Absolute joy, this collection. I think a lot of people will enjoy this. Definitely great stories to read in between your reads. They're weird, they're wonderful, lots of delight. Yeah, really allows you to see sort of the headspace of Ling Ma and where she shapes her worlds or how she forms them. And yeah, it's like the first story, which is set in LA, where she houses 100 ex-boyfriends. Her husband speaks in dollar signs. Yeah, it's just lots of weird and wacky worlds. Lots of fun. If you're a Ling Ma fan, you will definitely enjoy this. And yeah, can't wait to see what else she writes in the future. This was a lot of fun. In other news, I'm halfway through Either Or. Not even halfway, a little, two-thirds of the way through. I don't know how to feel about it, to be honest. The Celine in here feels much different than the Celine in The Idiot. And I don't know. I really don't know. I want to finish it to have complete thoughts and leave you with those than these sort of wishy-washy half-formed thoughts. But some funny bits in here. Love sort of the fiction that's involved, the name-dropping of books and stuff and albums and music and stuff. It's lots of fun. Hopefully going to finish this over the weekend. I also have some book mail. I feel terrible. I just feel like the last few videos I shot have just been like unboxings. I haven't done anything with my life. I've just been unboxing books. But yes, unbox these with me. This is... yes, Fleur, Jaeggy. Beautiful. Didn't realize how slim it was. I thought it was a little thicker, but excited to look at that cover. So gorgeous. Our little elementary school, our college ruled cover. Is that college ruled? Been meaning to read this for a while. And yeah, I think Kieran and someone else read Fleur, Jaeggy. So yeah, gonna hop on the train. Excited to read this. Sorry, Sweet Days of Discipline. Yes, love it. What is this about? Obsessive love and madness set in post-war Switzerland. Enough said. Okay, and then we have this. Yes. We have An Apprenticeship of the Book, or The Book of Pleasures. An Apprenticeship or the Book of Pleasures by Clarice Lispector. Done in this like high gloss cover, makes it feel a bit cheap. I feel like, I wish it was done in a little more, sort of like a matte texture. This would have been a lot better. Yeah, I originally saw this on, what's his name? Hi, sorry if the lighting's different. Technical difficulties. Honestly, is 128 gigabytes the new 64 gigabytes? I'm so done. Excited to read this. Seems like many people made this their gateway Lispector. Very interesting choice. I haven't heard about this until like I think this year, so excited to read this. Okay. Goodbye People by Gavin Lambert. I don't know what drew me to this book, but isn't that gorgeous? This like faux water reflection with this like classic book cover font. Seems very old school. Love it. I don't know what this is about, to be honest. Cool, incisive, yet essentially kind, the Goodbye People unfolds in the yawning chasm between real life in Los Angeles and the fantasies manufactured by its dominant business. Yeah, not quite sure what that means, but yeah, excited to read this as well. Okay, and then we have our last book package. Let's open it. Yes, Femme. A Romanian Lispector. Yes, I think I talked about this before, but yeah, not by Magda Cârneci. I am just out of whack today, y'all. Magda Cârneci. Yeah, I'm just gonna leave it at that. I don't really wanna know what this is about. I wanna enter this knowing nothing. So y'all can look it up on Goodreads. I mean, I'll have it linked down. You can find out yourself. But Femme, heard it's like Lispector, and yes, cannot wait. Compelling cover, is that not? I don't know, it's kind of basic. It's fun. It's fine. Yes, our books. Love that. Seems very minimalist. Wouldn't you agree? This literally just came in. The AirPods Max. Need I say more? Sadly, I lost my AirPods and I did not know what to do. I was thought, you know, I've had those AirPods for like a really long time. Time to upgrade? So yeah, we are doing an unboxing of this. A very unaesthetic one because This is what happens. Yes, so. We got it in the space gray. I've always had like white, well of course they've always been white, AirPods. So, I decided to go with something dark. I don't know how to do this. I'm not a tech reviewer. Ooh, okay. Look at her, she's gorge. Wow, heavy duty. Of course we got our little jack here. Ooh, yes, the microfilm condom. Some ASMR, anybody? How do I? Wow. Clackety clack clack. We did buy like shells to protect these, but they're coming tomorrow. Wow. Wait, first of all, how do you turn these on? Is my question. Should we? Okay, so. They fit snug. Do I press this button? How the hell do you turn these on? Are they charged? Do I have to charge them? Okay, well, we're gonna try and connect to my iPad. So let's figure that out first. Mi Box 4. I'm so confused. Give me a sec here, guys. Give me a sec.
There's actually a kind of hidden settings section for the AirPods Max. Now it's not really that hidden, but.
Okay. It just showed up on my iPad. I don't know how it did that. Magic. Apple's witchcraft. Incredible. Here we go. Media control. Oh, where did the buttons go? This side? Wow. Neat. Oh my god, that is so cool. Oh, that is so crazy. I'm listening to Miles Davis, Kind of Blue, but I can hear the cello and the strums of it, like the deep bass of it, like if I was within the cello. Wow. To be honest, sound quality is not bad. Oh, okay. Whoa, that is so weird. Noise cancellation is wild. I'm sorry, I've never had like premium headphones before, so this is like kind of insane. I love this. This is crazy. Absolutely wild. They feel great. I mean, I can imagine my neck straining if I wore it like this and going, yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think you'd have to like walk around and feel this out to see what it feels like. Okay, not bad though. I kind of love it. Yeah, hot girl summer has resurrected and come into fall. TikTok made me do it? I don't know. But you know what? Now I have something that I can like move between devices and that feels great once again. And yeah, I was gonna get the AirPods, what is it? The Pros? The latest ones, but there was an option to choose like the little ear thingies and there were different sizes and I was like, I don't know. Like, do you go into the store and have to try it out? Do they give you samplers? Are those samples even clean? Like, I feel like if people are trying things on, the dirtiest thing you're trying on are like ear stuff. That's just weird. Anyway, so got these. I have no more money. Yeah, literally rice and beans for the rest of the month. Nothing special. Yeah, but crazy. I'm so excited to use these. Okay, that's officially it. That was probably a very underwhelming AirPods Max review, but there you have it. Hope it was entertaining in some way, shape, or form. Bye.